to switch gears for a second. A couple exciting plays last week in the NFL. What you and I were discussing earlier, how about that Tyreek Hill play into the first half in Dallas?
Yeah, we usually use the word gate with everything, right? Now it's Mary when it's big plays like this. So this is the Hill Mary, isn't it? Putting that big wall in front of him. But how about the moves, the elusiveness to break that play against Dallas? Absolutely amazing. And then Sammy Watkins for the Rams.
Yeah.
Third and 30 plus. Not only did he convert, he scores a touchdown against the Giants in New York.
And the first time someone in the NFL has converted a third and 30 plus in the 21st century. Hard to believe. And they see right through that defensively as he'll be hit and taken down to the backfield. And they'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a third down. Throwing is Mahomes on third. And going deep for Hill. That's caught inside the 20.
36, what are you doing?
Play on third down for the Chiefs. 59 yards.
There will always be a place for methodically marching the ball downfield. But when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that, have explosive plays, that's often the difference in winning and losing. Those types of plays that can knock a defense off balance, that'll drive a team towards a victory.
He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete.
I'm going to turn the flat on like that EA. My man just jogging. Pushing right to the middle.
They get six on first down.
Got help coming behind. Off that. Come across right now. Good one.
Tracks at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play that time, and they'll look to convert on what will be a third and four. Looking to throw is Mahomes, escaping the pressure right. And he's got it. Touchdown, Chiefs.
That's bullcrap.
A great effort there.
Real bullcrap.
10 yards out, and the Chiefs are in for
six.
And he just did get those feet in there on the
That's
side.
Bullcrap. Oh, there you go.
Because I think if he had another half size,
could have been out of bounds. Shouldn't have been no good throw. That bench sit there, dog on side that man. They just dialed out right now. Good team now.
Let's field it a few yards into the end zone.
Look at this diamond.
That worked, but he stopped where he ultimately would have been, and he's simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. And last time, the turnover on the fumble, and they were in enemy territory, so that had to be very frustrating. Down on the scoreboard here, can't do it again.
You nailed every part of what was frustrating. Down on the scoreboard, had a drive going, had pushed it past the 50-yard line, so they thought they were in striking distance, and to come away with nothing, not a good feeling at all, to put it mildly. Now they can't afford to do that again.
Yeah, now can they get that bad taste out of their mouth here? Play action now, Winston. He's going to fire one deep over the... It's caught inside the 25. And he's going to be marked down deep into Kansas City territory. It's a big play there for the Buccaneers. 47 yards. First down and 10 now for the offensive group. Sims, and he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice gain like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now, because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
And he's going to drop this one. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. Call it a gain of 3. And that'll make it third down. Play action. action. Winston.
Come on,
it's a touchdown if he holds on. Instead, it's fourth down.
Coverage was very good that time. A nice job to smother him as the ball arrived, and that ensured an incomplete pass.
And it keeps 6 points off the board. And the 10-year bet knocks it through the goalpost. And they'll get it back within a point at 7-6. So the drive takes him inside the 10, but it ends with just 3.
And a nice job defensively to rise up and make sure they didn't get in.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. And the decision to bring it out will cost him about 5 yards as he'll get this only back to the 20. And out come the Chiefs now. And we'll see how this is played. Offensively, they've got the lead. Not a whole lot of time left. What do you think, Charles?
Well, it's tempting to try and add to your lead, but a mistake there, that can change things in a big way. I say go ahead, take the knee, get on out for the half.
On first down, Mahomes. He completes it to Wilson. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. It'll be a gain of 10 to start the drive out by a few inches. That'll be a first down.
That looked like a pretty good route combination there, because you've got to find a way to clear the guy running the drag. Because when you do, you just put the ball on him and then let him run.
He's got some space. Throwing the out route incomplete. It's Robinson. And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense, as they'll stop the clock with 26 seconds to go until halftime. From midfield, here's Mahomes. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Noah Spence. Now another timeout called for by the offense, as they stop it with 16 seconds to go in half number one. To throw on second down. Going for the deep ball. That'll be incomplete with 9 seconds now showing on the clock. He was looking for his tight end, Kelsey, and it's third down.
Have to give a lot of credit to the defense on that play. They were prepared. Ordinarily, when they take the big shot downfield to the big guy, that's usually a mismatch that the offense is used to winning. But the preparation showed for the defense, and they were able to bat it away.
Mahomes. Oh, the Buccaneer pressure too much. Down he goes. And we're going to get a timeout with 2 seconds remaining in the second quarter. And likely time for one final play here in the half, so they will go for it on fourth down. Final shot before the half for Mahomes. Going to let one fly for Robinson. And this is going to be incomplete. Time for a break. We've hit halftime. 2 quarters down. 2 still remain. We step aside. This is the NFL on EA Sports. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number 3. comes the Chiefs offensive unit as they'll have it to begin quarter number three. And on that last drive, went for it on fourth, turned it over. But good job by their defense, though. They held them to three, but this offense, they've got to be a little bit better, a little bit more careful here.
And sometimes when you see these calls on fourth down, when they decide to go for it, it's not necessarily the coach saying, I believe in my offense. Sometimes the coach saying, I believe in my defense. I can afford to go for it here, because if we don't get it, I don't think we'll give up more than three. And that's exactly what happened.
You think
there.
That factored in?
I do. I think that he had that in his mind going into the game, that I'm going to be aggressive on offense because I know I've got a defense that can hold up their end.
So the incomplete pass brings up second down. Mahomes going to hand it off to Hunt. And able to stay on his feet past the 30 to about the 33-yard line. 8 yards on the run there, and that leaves him with third and just a couple. On third down, that's Hunt. And he's going to have a first down as he's brought down at the 44-yard line. An 11-yard pickup, and it's enough for a Chiefs first down.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball and protect this lead. Give it to the backs, put a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them. They'll get five out of the scramble. It's second down.
While you admire anyone trying to pick up an additional couple of yards, they're just not worth it when you take shots like that. Quarterbacks have to stay in the game and stay on the field.
Second down of the offense needing 5 yards. Play fake there to Hunt. Now Mahomes. They'll roll him out right. It's brought in by Harris. And they're able to get this one down to the 25. A good pick up there. 26 yards. Mahomes now on first down. Eluding the pressure right. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Hunt. And he'll be brought down at the 21, just shy of the 20 in the red zone. It'll be a 3-yard gain, and that'll make it second down. They fake the give. Now Mahomes. Buying time to his left. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
That would have been a great catch, but it's real difficult to hold on to it because it was contested all the way. Would have been a great play if he'd been able to hold that one in.
Again, they'll throw with Mahomes. Trying to get it to Robinson, and it's intercepted.
Just gone, man. What are you doing? Stupid that EA.
His guys will get the football back. First possession of the third quarter, an interception.
No, that's supposed to be gone. Sit down, man. This dude stepping in the same spot. Nobody gonna do that. Nowhere, man. Nobody nervous like this. Like you got something. All you gotta do is let him run, man. Camera's too slow, man.
Nope, I've heard stories about teams actually doing that back in the good old days.
Winston now. Flushed out right. Looking down. And got his man complete. A big play that time for Tampa Bay. 51 yards.
Looked like the defense put pretty good pressure on him, but he's able to flush out to his right to try and evade people. On the run, had to get on his horse. Still accurately throws a nice pass for a first down.
Man, 3-man front. Now we're out there. Kill him.
And he'll give it here to his running back. Credit him with a 1-yard gain there to make it second and 9.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, this is the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
Now a second down throw for Winston. Under pressure, and he will go down. Sacked back at the 38.
The game plan for any defense is finding ways to make a quarterback uncomfortable in the pocket. When you bring pressure from all angles, you never know who's going to get home. In this case, the left cornerback, right in the face of him, puts him down.
Third and long for Winston.
Look at that, baby.
Incomplete.
idea there, trying to throw it to the sideline, but he let him just a little bit too much, trying to get it out to his receiver. Ends up falling to the ground incomplete.
They're going to try for it on fourth. Winston stays out there.
Good cover, Paul.
Play fake. Winston.
Get him down. Get him down. That's punt.
Picked off by Derek Johnson. And his guys will take over at the 30-yard line.
That'll work out.
This is a defense that can confuse even the best of quarterbacks with their zone schemes. And here you've got a linebacker that's going to stay at home and just sit down in that zone. And this one basically comes right to him.
They'll start with Hunt on the ground. And tough going there as he'll only get it up to about the 31. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine.
I'd say they've got to find a way to get him going. He's such a big part of their offense. I wonder if they might throw it a little and come back to the run.
Anything, because you're right. He's pretty much been completely neutralized. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
Cade Wilson.
Ball.
Right. He goes down.
Ooh, that'd been mad at ball pop out of
inside the 25. A gain of 39 that time. And the young buck showing that ability, that agility to dance outside of the pocket, complete the deep ball.
Here we come, big hit.
The coaching staff didn't have their heart rate accelerate a little bit there, right? Anytime you have those young quarterbacks and they get outside of the pocket, you're just hoping that they make good decisions, because so many things can happen that can go wrong when you throw it downfield like that. He got away with it there, and in a big way.
And it's first and goal now, but still 10 yards to go. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll go down, and that will do it for the third quarter of action. Back now in Tampa. This one's still anybody's ball game. It's a one-point difference here as we begin the fourth quarter of play. Stay on the ground again. It's able to push his way forward here for a good little game. Give him right around four on the carry. We'll see if they want to keep pounding here on third and goal. They'll try to run
not today.
He'll go backwards, losing yardage to the five. And a loss of three to bring up four.
They tried to run right into the teeth of the defense on third down, but looked like those teeth were pretty sharp.
They were having absolutely none of it. Stuffed them for a loss.
Yeah, couldn't get any coverage in front and move people aside in order to run the ball.
So they get the three here, but you wonder whether that's going to be enough.
Yeah, I mean, you've now made it so they need a touchdown rather than a field goal to catch them. But you're right. If they'd gotten six out of that drive, this would be a much different game.
Let's field it a few yards into the end zone. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. Now the Buccaneers offense gets ready to head back onto the field. And the interception last time on the opponent's side of the field, certainly not what they wanted.
Put it mildly, that is so frustrating, because that signifies there's a drive going on. You're in a good spot, great place to run some of your best offense. Instead, they turn the ball over.
Keep this up. Lift it. Last time. Take it long.
See if they can avoid doing it here. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. They get five out of that one, and it moves the chains.
So many
teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. That's almost a tendency breaker.
And the hole closes quickly there. He gets maybe a couple up to the 38.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of two. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. Second and eight.
Had him start, didn't he?
To the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
That'll wind up going for a loss of four. And that's going to lead to a third and 11. And, of course, the quarterback in this situation, he's realizing time is becoming a factor. Let's see if they can get some points on the board here late. On third down, Winston. Incomplete. He had his hands on it but couldn't pick it. But it's now fourth down. I guess they're in a situation now, fourth quarter, where they're forced to take some chances, but I don't know that that was the type of a chance you want to take.
And that one could very easily have been intercepted. And if it does get picked off, that could possibly seal this one.
One third down, fella. That's all we need.
One score down. Here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. And they're going to go soft on the corners. Desperation time. Winston on fourth down. Flush to his right. And this is caught by Jackson. 20 yards on the pickup there. And it'll give the Bucs a first down. Felt compelled to go for it there on fourth down, trailing in the fourth quarter. They got it done.
And there's always a lot of pressure on a fourth down call. Doesn't matter the distance. Stuck to get it done, as you noted, and they did.
Jameis now on first down. They go with a shuffle pass, and it's complete. Give him a couple on the catch. It's second and eight.
Okay.
Time for a break. We'll come back for the electrifying conclusion after this. Offense walks to the line for play number 7 of the drive. The play fake to Sims. Now Winston. It's caught by Mike Evans. 23 yards on the play.
Well, they picked up a little bit of yardage there, and now, in this situation, should be in no hurry to run a play really fast. Let the clock wind down.
And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. And they'll send the tight end in motion. Back to throw. Over the middle to Evans.
Good call, Debo.
Touchdown, Buccaneers.
That holy boy out, man.
Mike Evans from 21 yards away. And the Bucs have taken the lead here in the fourth. He's got it. And this is indeed up to a 3-point lead. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And he'll be knocked down sideways. And now here comes Kansas City. They're only in need of a field goal, a decent amount of time on the clock. So tell me if I'm wrong. You don't have to be too panicked here.
No, not at all. I agree with you. And this is where your preparation and your confidence comes into play. They've worked on these situations.
They practice this all the time.
They practice it all the time. They know what they want to get done. And in a lot of cases, the great competitors, they love this situation. They think they can go ahead and get it done.
They practiced it. We'll see if practice makes perfect. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave them with a second and two.
First play of the drive. Let's get credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
Travis Kelce, the Pro Bowl tight end, the intended target, and it's third and short. But not to get too overcritical there, because he knows what he's doing, but his shoulders looked a little off kilter there when he threw that.
I don't think you're being overly critical there. You're just analyzing it, and he gets those shoulders right. That pass will go from incomplete to complete.
They'll go screen here to Hunt. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down.
Why are you not there on this position, Max?
It's a 7-yard gain there, and it's good enough to move the chains.
Roll over, man. Come on. You want to come over there. No, champion.
Forced out to his left. And some room to work. And he'll be out of bounds up near the 45 at the 44. He'll get 8 on the scramble there. It'll be second and a couple.
Now, that was not a bad scramble there on first down. He didn't force it, nor did he throw it away. He was able to take off, and now he made it a very manageable second and short.
Here we go now.
Back to throw. Rolling to his right. They find some open field here. Nowhere to go downfield, but he's able to get out of bounds and stop the clock here with a first down. Late in the game, defense trying to avoid a big play. He's able to work out of the passing game, turn it into a run, pick up the first, and stop the clock as well.
And you know, in this situation, everything is sped up. The intensity, the thinking, everyone's movement. But for a quarterback, he has to continue to be what we call flatliner. Level in everything he does, and read the clock, feel it in the pocket, and go at the appropriate time. The goal of a wide receiver screen is get enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there swarming to it and not allowing that to happen? Did not let him get downfield.
In motion right is Wilson. He's back to throw. Being chased out left.
I'm a football.
Work it inside the 30 to the 29-yard line. And now before this first down play, we're going to get a timeout here, as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the ball game. And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. Escaping the pressure right. He'll leave it for Hunt, complete. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. First down for the Chiefs, solid chunk of yardage, 17 on the play. And they will get the timeout. So 3 seconds remaining, and they can trot out the field goal unit and try to send this one to overtime. So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today. And a timeout comes in. The whistles blow with 3 seconds remaining. So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today.
Ooh, that tickled me. Lord, that man, he got frozen, y'all. That December freeze came through on him. That cold snap. Hey. Good call, Debo. Jermaine, good play call. Guys, yeah, appreciate that. Y'all helped me out. Nice victory. Started the morning off. Go back and look at this play. So, y'all, I got this from Debo. It was one of my old plays. I've been running, but Debo told me how to make it where you can get Mike Evans open. Instead of him being caught up in all them zones, you put that tight end in a drag, move him out, and they're going to pull. If they ain't in that man, he wasn't in the man, the double move over there on the right. So the drag gonna pull the cover down just a little bit. The middle linebacker, he put him down just a little bit for me to sweep that ball through there on a high point pass for the TD. Good call, Debo. Appreciate it. Man, Grand Club, stick together, win together. Peace.